In business, the COVID-19 pandemic has left the government with no other option but to follow the draconian measures of a lockdown in some states. However, it has granted essential services sectors to continue operation. While this is a necessity, big retailers in the country still have a share of concerns. And joining me live via Skype is Haresh Keswani, Group Managing Director of SPAR Nigeria Limited. Thank you, Haresh, for joining us.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Good evening, and thank you for joining us.
Yep. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Now, I understand that essential services like yours have been allowed to operate despite the lockdown. What has been your experience so far?
Well, we are experiencing a lot of challenges to keep our businesses running. Primarily, modern retail is just not keeping the shops open that makes the business happen or be able to satisfy our customers. It's a chain of events, starting from the manufacturers being able to provide the goods delivered to our stores, and also the movement of our staff who need to come to work and serve the customers. And as you know, in the modern retail today, our staff are in the front line trying to provide service to the various customers. However, without any goods, there's a lot of disappointments which the customers are experiencing, who themselves are taking some sort of a risk to leave their homes to come and do shopping. And this is currently a major challenge. And we have reached out to various agencies in the government and expressed this. And they are, I know they're trying to do their best, but let's see what happens. We have gone into the second, what they call lockdown 2.0. I hope by next week things should improve, at least in the terms of supplies.
Interesting you didn't make mention of supplies, Haresh. Now, let's look at accessibility and availability of products. How have you managed this scarcity as your retail stores have to be restocked even more frequently?
Yeah, so should I give you any numbers? I mean, typically our fill rates, what we call the amount of orders we place and what we actually get, is currently just below 26%. So we order 100 different products, only 26 get delivered. And this is a big challenge. This is a big challenge. And this is a challenge every manufacturer, be it a multinational, be it a SME, be it a farmer, they just cannot get the goods over to the modern retailers. And as you may be aware, that we also have started home delivery recently. And this home delivery was prima facie just to facilitate our customers not to leave their homes, stay safe, and try and avoid them in any kind of any inconvenience they may face when they are going out for shopping. But again, here, we have a challenge with the logistics companies who are not able to get down to our stores to pick up those deliveries and deliver on time. So it's a challenge. I mean, look, it's not easy.
Yeah.
Are we making money? Are we doing good business? No, the answer is no. But it's not about money. At this moment, we do not think about money. We think about how can we do what is expected from us. If a consumer needs an essential item, how can we serve him? That's the key thing here. And we are very fortunate at SPAR that our staff are totally aligned with that philosophy. They come every day in the morning, want to serve the customers. In fact, since the last 2 weeks, every morning they do a Thanksgiving prayers and say, you know what, let's serve the customers, let's put in our best.
Right. Now, Haresh, in your managing capacity as one of the biggest retail outlets we have in Nigeria, how would you say the government has helped out to ensure easy operation this period?
Well, you know, the truth be said, they are really trying. But we've got letters from the various ministries of clearance that we should be in business. We've got letters from the police saying that the safe passage of goods should be allowed. But that's all fine. That's all beautiful. But the key question is, every different individual who looks at the letter relates it differently. relates it very differently, and that's a challenge, right?
Yes,
so
yes.
There is something missing, which I call understanding the empathy which is required in this time where essential goods should be moved with speed and reach the stores, so the consumers who are taking the risk of going out for shopping get what they want. And that's a simple message.
All right, just before I let you go tonight, now, how would you say that this lockdown could impact your earnings in the coming months should the lockdown continue?
Well, that's something which I tell you, I don't want to even think about it now. The question is scaling over the current situation ASAP as soon as possible, and all of us need to be safe. That's paramount. That's paramount. Money, profits, yes. We know that we have huge overheads because the businesses do not really compensate what we spend every day to keep our stores up. However, we feel and we believe that where there is life, there's always another chance, another hope that we will always come back and we will make our buddies.
Group Managing Director of Spar Nigeria, Mr. Aresh Keswani, thank you for your time and for joining us on News on the Hour.
Thank you. Stay safe.
You too.